Gives us the world's first recognized activist, written by a truth soldier. Jesus was a man that walked amongst us. He walked with the love of pure truth in his heart and soul, for God is the truth. His message was very simply, as all truth is always very simple. Jesus was recognized for his loving and caring. He spread the truth, and in doing so, obviously, he also made those around him aware of the evils that existed in society. He would speak to the lonely, the sick, the crippled, the abused, the hated, the ignored, the starving, and the dying. He shared love with all that he spoke with or touched. His touch was the touch of the Spirit of God. His touch gave strength to the weakest and most abused. His touch was so soft and tender. The pure Spirit of God gave his touch the strength to heal. His touch gave the crippled the strength to walk, move, or talk. His tender touch gave the most precious gift of all. It gave him the ability to love. For without truth there will never be any love. Jesus spread the pure love of God. Everywhere he traveled, his legacy grew behind him. He began to have more and more followers, for the followers sought the truth and the love of God. Jesus never wanted you to follow him. He wanted you to go with the love of God and share your love of truth with others. Jesus had the Spirit of truth in him. Jesus knew that the love of God could never be known if one did not live with pure truth in their hearts and souls. Jesus shared a message from God. He shared the message that to be whole one needs to be pure and natural. One could never achieve the love of God without being pure. Jesus did not just spread the love of God. He showed the lost souls the path to pure love. He showed the path to the Spirit of God. Jesus never wrote a word in his life, for he did not need to, for the message of love and wisdom he shared would live on forever. The message was very clear. He showed that once one reached the love of God, one would then continue on in their lives doing the same as Jesus did. And that is to spread truth, and this would lead to peace and harmony. One only had to follow a very simple path. That path being to always seek all the truth and then to always speak all the truth. For all truth leads to God. For God is the whole truth. But this was not to be, for humans had another love, and it is the totally selfish love of money. This love of money has grown so much now and has made life so undeservedly easy for too many that the masses no longer had any need to seek the love of God. God created a perfect paradise for all whales, sharks, birds, dolphins, and every living thing. He created our living earth. But the lovers of money have been on an insane mission of consuming everything, and in the process, destroying all the natural beauty that God created. The money masters have been on an insane path to complete destruction. The power to create money out of thin air has made the money masters completely insane. This insanity has grown because the truth of God is pure and absolute, and the absolute opposite of truth is insanity. For the further one goes from truth, the closer one gets to insanity. The money masters have created their mega corporations at the cost of consuming everything that was beautiful and natural. This pyramid of insanity has now reached the very base of the pyramid. The pyramid is now about to collapse. The future of Mother Earth is doomed because humans have chosen to be guided by the insanity of the money masters and their illusion of truth. Earth is doomed for humanity has forgotten Jesus' message. Money has created a false reality of truth. The corporations always hide all their insanity and evil behind what they call corporate image. This beautiful image is very easy to maintain when one has a never-ending ability to create unlimited money out of nothing. These mega corporations have been raping, killing, blowing up, bulldozing and puncturing the very heart of God. For what humans seem to have never realized is that Earth is the very heart of God. The lovers of money have now driven a dagger into the very center of God's heart. They have repeatedly stabbed God's heart. God has been very strong and has endured much pain and suffering, as I and Jesus have. These attacks on the purity and natural love of God could not go on. For you see, God is real and God only needed one thing from you in return. He needed you to return love. For without the pure love of God, humanity would die. Jesus was killed for the love he shared. The money lovers are now killing all truth and all those that seek and speak the truth. The insane money masters are going to kill us all because you continue to do the deeds of the evil corporations and not the deeds of God. God's heart is now bleeding. A final blow has been given to the very core of God's heart. That being Mother Earth. British Petroleum has ruptured the heart of God. God's heart is still pulsing. Huge cracks up to 30 miles from the rupture are opening and closing as God breathes. These huge cracks are letting out the very blood in God's heart. The seas are now turning to blood. The blood is now spreading over the oceans, killing all living things, and soon the blood of God will be spread over the whole planet. God's last tear will be a tear of blood, for God is crying. So soon you will have God's rain of bloody tears fall. God gave you everything, but you gave no love back, for your selfish, insane love of money is all you wanted. Your ungiving selfishness is going to kill everything that God created. You did not love the perfect balance of nature God shared with you. You did not love the flowers that the bees and butterflies landed on. You created your Monsanto corporation to alter and destroy the genetics of life itself. Your corporate media have kept all truth from the people, and your corrupt media have instead presented false truths to the people. You first killed Jesus, then you went about your mission of killing all other activists of truth. Your insanity truly believed that you could just continue killing all that was natural and beautiful, for the truth of God is the most natural beauty of all. You did not understand the message from Jesus. The writers about Jesus never wrote the whole truth. God never said that he would forgive you if you came to ask for forgiveness, if you did not walk on earth always seeking and speaking the truth. God never told you that you were powerless to defeat evil. God told us how to do it. God told you to be godly and gave you his creation to live on and to take care of. He gave you a natural paradise. But you chose to not take care of it. God could not continue to exist if you did not love him. Now your love of money has brought about the death of God himself. God is dying because God is no longer in your heart. With no humans on earth having God in their hearts, then where would God be? He would no longer exist, nor would you. So your lack of love for truth has extinguished the light of truth. Soon the oil volcano in the Gulf of Mexico will darken this planet. Life will cease and the final dark ages will be born, which has always been the insane Satanist's goal. The Satanists are so insane that they do not believe any truth. They do not believe that they also will cease to exist. The Satanist Illuminati believe that Lucifer can exist without the presence of God. Again, they never believe any truth. Lucifer is not a god. Satan only exists in the minds of the insane. For the insane seek no truth. For there is only one truth. And God of the light of heaven is the only truth. Humanity has become so insane. Humanity can no longer count on God. God asked you to listen and to be godly, but you chose not to be. God cannot control your mind, for God gave you conscience and gave you the power to choose. You chose greed and selfishness. You killed Jesus. I have sent a truth soldier to you, and you have chosen to attempt to kill him numerous times. I have been strong enough to spare his life till now. But he has been left severely injured. Yet you still try to harm him. Humanity has not paid heed to the messages from the truth soldier. Humanity has not tried to help or protect the truth. Now you have pierced my heart, and my blood is now beginning to cover the seas. My blood is now going up the Atlantic. The insane corporations now want to blow God's heart up with a nuclear weapon. They want to angle drill and insert a nuclear device into the bottom of the well in the Gulf of Mexico. The insane corporations believe that they can ignite a fusion device and melt the rock crust of the earth and cause this to seal the leaks. They do not understand that they will ignite the methane and the massive explosion will weaken the crust of the earth. Then the weight of the ocean will collapse God's heart and will kill this planet, and God will then die. And so will you. Will you now choose the path of God and stop doing the deeds of the insane money masters and their corporations? The bees are dying, the butterflies are dying, the fish and whales are dying. God is dying. Will you now accept the truth of God and Jesus, an activist and the truth soldier? God has armed the truth soldier with the wisdom of time. God has armed the truth soldier with the most powerful weapon of all. God has armed the truth soldier with the love of God. Will you now join the army of truth? Will you become a truth soldier? Will you bring God back into your life and give God your love? God can only perish without your love. For God and everything else is all one. There is no God without truth. There is no God without you, and soon there will be no you without God. So be good. Take the O out of good and you've got God. Oh God, you are the answer. When the seeds of truth are sown, the grassroots truth revolution will blossom from the enlightenment. Please do a search online this article. Oldest Bible found in Palestine, Jesus was a servant of God and not God himself. Trinity false. Follow a truth soldier on www.twitter.com/DanieLTowsey. Readers comments. Brian ZSLNKA says, the father of the liars has a lot of power in today's world, but that world is coming to an end. This I know because of the words long written down. Truth is God and truth will stand forever. Amen. When enough people realize that truth is more valuable than the almighty dollar, the old world of lies will simply die and then we can rebuild a new world. It is never too late to build a better world. Tommy Douglas. Brian ZSLNKA says, I am a truth soldier. Daniel J. Towsey says, good stuff. Hi. Come join me at danieltowsey.wordpress.com. Telling the truth in times of universal deceit is a revolutionary act. Brian ZSLNKA says, I find it interesting that the ex-president's Bushes have no quotes on truth. There are a few from George Washington and Abe Lincoln and other good men. Update note. This article was written while the Gulf of Mexico disaster was unfolding. Please read my newer article about the destruction of the Gulf of Mexico. Jesus, the world's first recognized activist.